While many scientists are awaiting a potential new eruption of the recognized volcano in Iceland, something unexpected occurred at another volcano in the country. As, on January 4th of 2024, the ground began to rapidly subside underneath Iceland's ice-covered Grímsvötn volcano, and this occurred alongside an unusually strong earthquake swarm. While these quakes were low in magnitude, they were still significant as they could indicate the presence of shallow magma. As a result, Grímsvötn's alert level was raised from green to yellow on the same day, marking the first time that the single most active volcano in Iceland had been placed at a raised alert level since October of 2022. The amount of ground subsidence during the earthquake swarm at Grímsvötn during a 60-minute period was measured to total 1 meter or 3.3 feet. This subsidence indicates that a glacial flood is likely about to occur or is already underway, which is known as a jökulhlaup. While the exact relationship between these jökulhlaups and volcanic eruptions is still debated, it is widely accepted that on several occasions a jökulhlaup preceded or coincided with a volcanic eruption. This occurred in 1922, 1938, 1954, and most recently in 2004. Although jökulhlaups occur around the planet for varying reasons, when they originate from the Grímsvötn volcano, which is largely buried underneath a thick ice sheet, they almost certainly are volcanic in origin. Since Grímsvötn has a presumably large volume magma chamber as indicated by its ability to produce highly voluminous, effusive, and explosive eruptions, it also has a large geothermal system consisting of abundant fumaroles which are buried beneath the thick ice sheet. These fumaroles regularly release volcanic gases at above the boiling point of water, which melts sections of the overlying glaciers, creating a thick subglacial lake which can have on the order of several cubic kilometers of water. The rate of melting responds to the movement of magma at depth, meaning that it can increase or decrease. All of this water eventually floods at a path of least resistance, creating a jökulhlaup that floods distant drainages of the volcano. You might hear all of this and think that the relationship between jökulhlaups and volcanic eruptions couldn't be more self-explanatory, as it is true that fresh lava erupted onto the surface or beneath a thick ice sheet can generate a glacial flood. However, this doesn't describe the full picture, as shown by Grímsvötn producing a jökulhlaup in 2004, 5 days before the eruption began. The reason this was believed to have occurred relates to the pressure exerted by the mass of overlying water and glacial ice on the volcano's magma chamber. While meltwater is piling up beneath the thick ice sheet, the notable mass of this material makes it incredibly difficult for a volcanic eruption to occur. For an eruption to occur, the tensile stress on rock overlying the magma chamber needs to become positive. This can occur quite quickly with the removal of a sufficient amount of overlying water and ice, causing lake propagation to begin and often leading to a volcanic eruption. Thus, although a volcanic eruption can trigger a jökulhlaup, a jökulhlaup can also trigger a volcanic eruption. However, most jökulhlaups from the Grímsvötn volcano have not led to volcanic eruptions, although statistics seem to suggest that each event carries with it a very low double-digit percentage chance of causing a volcanic eruption or occurring alongside one. For example, since Grímsvötn's last eruption in 2011, it has produced 11 separate jökulhlaups, not including the one which is potentially ongoing. And Grímsvötn often produces volcanic eruptions which are completely unrelated to jökulhlaups. With this being said, this large caldera complex volcano has been the most historically active in Iceland at least since 1000 CE. During that time, it has erupted 58 times, although there is a potential undercounting of these events until relatively recently, as in the last 100 years, 10 eruptions have occurred. On 5 occasions since Grímsvötn last erupted in 2011, has its alert level been raised either due to a jökulhlaup, earthquake swarm, or a combination of both? However, I must admit that the intensity of the latest sequence is the weakest among the five, so, in my opinion, I am not expecting an eruption to occur unless there are further developments. However, the increased alert level does suggest a slightly increased risk of an eruption occurring. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Kimberly Orr, for supporting this channel.